bitch, you can't keep up. You're looking like you bit too much. Boy, act right, cause it's cool. It's just too much sauce in the food for you. Too much sauce. I got too much sauce.
What's up, YouTube? Back with another video. I'm sorry I didn't get a video on Friday or whatever. But hell of shit went on Friday. I had to go do a whole bunch of, yeah, I was going through it on Friday. So excuse my voice. I think I'm getting sick, y'all. I don't know. Hope not. But so this video, I was thinking about it. I want to tell y'all a story about my, I wouldn't call him my first love, I'm calling him my first boyfriend. So it's basically gonna be a story about me having a first boyfriend at 12 and he was 16. Yeah, that was a big ass age gap. That I think that's rape. 13, 14, 15, 16, 4 years older. That's rape. You're 12. And yeah, but I consider that rape. I don't know. Look it up. Shit, me. But yeah, so I was 12 years old back in 2011, 2012. I was transferring from fifth grade. Oh, I said transferring. Like, I mean, anywho, I was going from fifth grade to sixth grade. And he was, I think, a sophomore. Or a junior, freshman, one of those. He was in high school. Just know that he was in high school. So, I met him through a best friend I had that time. Around that time. Me and her used to hang out. Me, I was overprotective, like I told y'all. My granddaddy ain't playing that shit, so I couldn't ever go nowhere. But she was a real friend. She actually came and sat on the porch with me every day. We hung out at my house. I couldn't go nowhere else. But she, you know, she ain't have no problem with it. She ain't getting mad about it. She did what she had to do to see me because she really wanted to fuck with me. That was my best friend. So one day, her cousins and her brother came over and a whole bunch of other group of boys. We sitting on the porch. And I was like, who that right there? She was like, girl, that's
my brother. And, you know, I had my eye on him.
I was like, okay, 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 okay. And so, so we walking down the street because I wanted to go down there and see him some more. But they was playing basketball, like, across the street, down the street. So me and her walking, you know, we just sitting on the little rock looking at them playing basketball. But, you know, my ass, I was looking at that particular boy. He was tall, skinny, light-skinned, of course. And he was cute. He had some nice-ass lips. You know, his edge was kind of, his edge was, you know, kind of fucked up. But I didn't care. He was cute to me. I don't know. And so I was like, Joy, hook me up with you doing. And then she was like, girl, that's my brother. He way older than us. And I'm like, how old he is? And she was telling me, you know, oh, he's 16. I'm like, so what? And I'm thinking to myself, like, Lincoln, don't do this. Stop trying to be grown. But I ain't care. He was cute as fuck to me. So I was like, if she ain't gonna shoot me a shot, I'm gonna shoot my shot myself. So after a while, she finally gave in. He gave me his number. Back, way back, it used to be, Kick used to be lit. So I got his Kick and Uvu. Uvu was the shit back during my time. Not no more, not Kick ain't popular no more. Somebody trying to bring it back, but nah. And so, that same night we met, we started talking, you know, I told him my situation, how I couldn't, you know, how old I am, what grade I'm in. He didn't care. He was like, you cute, I wanna fuck with you. And I was like, this is my first time a nigga actually, you know, wanna fuck with me, wanna, you know, get with me. Because niggas used to think I was ugly, nobody ain't wanna fuck with me. I used to get picked on bad back then. But this one particular nigga, he was like, he don't think nothing wrong with me, he think I'm cute, he wanna fuck with me, all this good stuff. So I was like,
I felt special.
I ain't felt special before. So, you know, of course, my little G ass gave him a chance, you know, kicked it off there. Me and him, every time his sister
came over, so he could see me. We hung out, I hung out with her sometimes, because I didn't want to become distant towards her and feel like
I put her brother over her and stuff like that. So, you know, I try to hang out with them both equally. So she won't feel distant or anything. Because I was a good friend. So, yeah. After a while, I tried to start going over to Joy House. Surprisingly, my granddad, you know, agreed to let me go over there. But in reality, I was going over there just to be with her brother. And, you know, sometimes I hang out with her. Sometimes I don't. I got to start going to the park. Me and him used to start hanging out more and more and more, seeing each other more. We was just getting close. Like, that was the best feeling ever to know I really had a boyfriend. It was my first boyfriend. So I was like, I was strong as fuck, y'all. I was
strong.
So it felt good. You know, he never cheated on me. He never acted different towards me. He never lied to me. He was a good boy. He was a good nigga. And I was like, you know, damn, it's my first boyfriend, and he has not hurt me yet, nothing. And mind you, we ain't think about sex, nothing nasty. He ain't never think about doing nothing nasty to me. He never touched me. Me and him was just like boyfriend and girlfriend lovebirds. We never had none of that other nasty shit in between us.
He was just, and he knew my age, so that would have been a big ass no-no.
No-no. And I didn't even know about sex then. I mean, I've seen a dick before, yeah, a picture, but I didn't even know about, I was 12, I was little, I ain't had no experience to nothing, I ain't do nothing. So, our first kiss,
rewind,
that's where, our first kiss, we had just sitting on the porch. He came over to say hey before it started raining, and you know, I was acting funny, and Joel was like, how long y'all been talking together? Why you
haven't kissed me? I'm like, I never kissed nobody before. She said, girl, you scared? You better go out there and kiss your man.
So I was like, girl, bye. I walked out there, you know, me and him talking. He's like, he got to go somewhere. He got to do something. So he'll hit me up later. I was like, I'm going to miss you, blah, blah, blah. And he was like, come here. He grabbed me on my chin.
And we had our first kiss. And surprisingly, my first kiss was good. I kissed
him. Like, I kissed the nigga before. Like, it was like a tongue kiss, and he just got through eating peanut butter jelly. It was nasty, but
it was worth it. His lips, oof. Y'all, my first kiss was the shit.
Then after we kissed, it started raining. That.
But that kiss, oh gosh, y'all.
I loved that kiss. That was the best kiss I ever had. This was my first kiss, but
that kiss was good, y'all. So after that,
me and him ended up staying together for 7 months. 7 straight months. Until,
y'all, something happened.
So his cousin named Joshua, he had a huge crush on me back then, you know.
He always tried to find a way
for us to get, like, break up. Because he liked me. And so one day, you know, I'm home. I did not get no text from him, no call from him the whole day. I'm trying to figure out what the fuck going on. So
his cousin or somebody told me
that he was in Pine Haven. It was like across town, the south side, was some apartments that he was somewhere over there when he was flirting with another girl. So, you know, I didn't believe it. So I blew up his shit. He still didn't answer. So, you know, he finally texted me. I'm like, is it true? Blah, blah, blah. He was going over the question I was asking him. So that made me think, you know, he was fucking talking to somebody else. 2 days later, after I stopped talking to him, come find out, he was cheating on me with my cousin that I didn't even know about, my dad's side. A big fat bitch. But that still ain't stopped me from fucking with him. We were still on and off. Because that was my first boyfriend. I couldn't let him go like that. I'm not going to say his name. I really loved him. I'm going to call him him. I was about to say his name. But, me and him was on and off. Then we ended up having to, you know, call it quits. Because we just wasn't the same no more. We was, like, together for, like, until I was 13, 14. Yeah, we was together for a long minute. So, is it raining? Oh, just windy. But, yeah, that was my first little boyfriend, y'all. He was way older than me, sadly. Do I still keep in contact with him today? Sometimes he texts me, sometimes he don't. Oh, forgot. When my granddad died, he was the first one to call me. He's still there for me sometimes. He grown now, y'all. So, because I'm 17 now, so he 18, 19. Nah, blah, blah, blah. 18, 19, 20. He about like 20, 21, so he grown. But yeah, we still keep in touch, you know, keep in contact sometimes. Sometimes I text him, sometimes he texts me, and sometimes I don't text him back because that's just me. I don't associate with exes. You're an ex for a reason. Fuck you. Especially when you know you did something. Don't try to run back. No. And so, yeah, that's a little, you know, story. Spilling a little tea with y'all about my first boyfriend.
He was 16 and I was 12. So, subscribe, like, and comment.
Fuck with me. And if you don't fuck with me, fuck you. And I'll get back with y'all. I can't fucking talk. I will get back with y'all in the next video. Bye.
Sorry that you can't keep up. You're looking like you bit too much. Boy, act right, cause it's cool. It's just too much sauce in the food for you. Too.